everybody! Welcome to PCBWay channel. This is Louisa.
This is Amy.
Well, Amy is one of our most senior customer service in PCBWay, and she has been working here for more than 4 years. I'm so happy you're here.
Thank you for having me here. Today, I will be the representative to answer some questions about PCBA order placing.
Well, last time, Leslie and Andrew just elaborated the most basic and most frequently asked question about PCB assembly. And today, we'll focus on some details. So let's just get started. Amy, working in a PCB prototype company, we'll inevitably meet some urgent orders. For PCB order, our customers can choose extra urgent service to meet their needs. Then do we also offer expedited service for PCB assembly?
Sure. We can expedite assembly service when all components are ready. For components procurement, it normally takes a certain time to process. So the room to speed up this process is little.
Fully understand, Amy. As you know, when placing an order, some makers may have the ideas like, I want blank PCB and components separately for 5 pieces, and another 5 pieces which are assembly completed. So can it be achieved?
Yes, there's no problem to choose different quantity for PCBs and assemble boards, but the PCB quantity should be larger than assemble boards.
It goes without saying.
The number of PCB and the number of PCBA are not necessarily the same, but the MOQ for PCB is 5 and no MOQ for assemble boards.
Thanks for your elaboration. Amy, for PCBA service, we provide 3 kinds of flexible options for parts supply, right?
Yes.
They are customer supply parts, PCBWay supply parts, and if you supply some parts, we do the rest. So, what issues are important for customer supply parts?
There are 3 aspects. The first one is markings. Each packaging should include the part number, package, value information, same as the ones in BOM. It's better to add the designators to each package if you can. If there's anything different from information in BOM, please remember to contact us to create a BOM in advance. The second one is parts overage. You know, we must prepare some extra components to prevent the unnecessary parts damage or loss. For resistors, capacitors, and diodes with the following packages, the required minimal quantity is 50 pieces, including 30 pieces extra over assembly quantity. For example, if the assembly quantity is 40 pieces, 40 plus 30, then we will need 70 pieces in total. For resistors, capacitors, diodes with other types of packages, the required minimal quantity will be 100 pieces, including 50 pieces extra over assembly quantity. As a means of improving efficiency and security, a small number of excess is also requested for expensive parts such as IC, BGA, QFP, connectors, etc. And the quantity can be 1 to 5 pieces based on the total quantity of assemblies. The last one is the packaging of parts. Based on our experience, here's some advice. SMT parts that are not supplied on reels should be on one continuous strip of tape. If there's a need to assemble the same SMT part on different boards, please keep them in the continuous strip of tape or on the reels. Do not cut them into strips. Furthermore, components on the tube or chain are good for assembly as well.
Thanks for your clear explanation, Amy. And as you know, it's a common situation that we cannot find a few components just due to uncontrollable factors. Then will we recommend a substitute in the quotation?
Yes, it's a part of our job. If our customer accepts to use substitute for assembly, then you can list a column of substitutes in BOM. At the same time, the detailed specification of components can help a lot. Don't forget to write it down in your BOM file.
Amy, What will happen if the information in the sanctuary file and the bone files are different? I know sometimes the parts are not sorted just because the bone file didn't include enough information.
Normally, we purchase and solder the parts just based on your bone file, and the central file is just used to confirm the position of each part. So it's important to make sure the bone list includes all the parts you need.
Amy, after assembly, are there any tests to make everything work well?
Of course, yes. Normally, we will do AOI test after assembly. As for IC or BGA area, we can do X-ray test if that's a request from our customers, and the test results will be provided to them for review. What's more, with just testing the LEDs after assembly, when your components include some. Otherwise, the result may have around 2% failure.
Thanks, Amy. I bet our customers need to provide relative documents for testing service, right?
Yes, there are three different situations.
Then can you explain it to our PCB wearers?
Sure, for LED testing, we will require them to send us the testing procedures with pictures showed. For function test, the test methods are needed, including the test steps and pictures. Moreover, it will be better if there's any video for reference. Oh, our assembly factory only has a conventional universal meter, so please send us the specific test tools where it's necessary to test your project. For both LED testing and function testing, the test fee will be confirmed and charged after testing, which is calculated according to the time used.
Okay, let's come to the topic of programming. Can we do the programming for our customers when the assembly and testing is completed?
Of course, we can program some parts. If you have this need, just let us know which parts in the BOM you need us to do programming, and send us the relevant bootloader files, which usually is .hex file. Then our engineer will check whether we can do it and code for the extra programming fee.
Then, Amy, would you mind explaining deeper about IC programming?
No problem. IC programming will be performed before the chips are mounted on board. You can contact your old customer service for details. Besides, we also have a qualified programming management system. We understand the importance of intellectual property. We'll sign a non-disclosure agreement document on the request of customer in order to protect the IP rights.
Quite professional. And the next question is, will we send pictures to our customer for assembly review?
Good question. During the manufacture process, PCBWay will send sample pictures to you to confirm everything is correct. But please note that we just put the PTH parts on the position, and the PTH parts are not soldered yet. If you find any direction or position problem, we can make easy corrections. After you confirm the sample pictures, we will finish the soldering of PTH parts.
So, Amy, once the sample picture is confirmed, how long will it take to ship out the assembled boards?
It depends, because there's a difference between orders, like assembly quantity, PTH components quantity, whether there are special procedures or not. But I can tell an approximate duration. For a prototype order, it usually takes 3 working days. For small and medium quantity orders, it usually takes 5 working days. If there's special requirement, like conformal coating and function testing, we need to check the complexity to confirm the final lead time.
Then, Amy, will we ship the stencil back when we finish the assembly?
Usually, we will not ship the stencil back to you. It will be stored in our warehouse for the use of repeat order in the future. If you really need it, the SMD stencil can be shipped to you too. Well, you have to pay for the extra shipping cost. The stencil with framework is much heavier than PCB. When shipped, it adds a lot of weight. which cause much higher shipping cost.
It's a user-friendly method, Amy. Everyone can make judgments based on the demand and cost. And today's last question is, after receiving the board, what to do if there's any defects?
You're always encouraged to contact our after-sales team at any time and use pictures or videos to show the issue. And it will be better if you can analyze the reason to help us to solve problems soon. If the problem is related to components, apart from the part number, please tell us the relevant designator in the BOM too. By the way, please do not repair the defective boards by yourself before we confirm the real reason.
Amy, thanks so much for coming through.
I will be happy if my answers can help our customers to know our service better.
Oh, you're just so nice. And that's all we prepared for you guys today. If you like this video, don't forget to click subscribe and like below, please. That really means a lot to us. Moreover, if you have more questions, just leave it below in the comment or contact feedback@pcbway.com. We'll reply to you quickly and professionally. See you. Bye-bye.